that is LCM. Yes, children. LCM, which is the full form of LCM is least common multiple. Yes, children. Least common multiple. So, what is least common multiple? Yes, children. Yes.
It is the smallest number which is a multiple of each of the numbers.
As we have already started our HCF and we have completed it, during HCF we always find the factors and we choose the highest factor. But in LCM we are going to find out the multiples because it is least common multiple. So we are going to find out the multiple. And as it is least common multiple, so we are going to find out the lowest common multiple of the given numbers. Okay? So we are having three methods to find out LCM. What are the three methods?
Common multiple method, prime factorization method, division method.
So as we have already read in HCF, we also had three methods. Here also we are having three methods, that are common multiple method, prime factorization method and division method. Okay, children? Okay, class. So let us start with our first method, that is common multiple method. So let us learn how to get LCM in common multiple method.
So all of you see here one example is written. Find the LCM of 12 and 18. So we have to find out the lowest common multiple of the two given numbers, that is 12 and 18. Okay, children?
So first of all, in step number 1, you have to write the multiples of 12 and 18. Okay?
So this is step number 1. Step 1.
Here you have to write down the multiples of 12 and 18.
Okay. So the multiples of 12 are 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, 72, and it goes on. Okay, children?
Next is the multiples of 18 we will write down.
Multiples of 18.
Okay, children?
So let us write down the multiples of 18, that is 18, 36, 54, 72, 19, and it goes on.
And it goes on. So in step number 1, we have to write the multiples of the given numbers. Step number 2, we have to find out the common in the given numbers. So the given numbers are 12 and 18. And we have already written the multiples. Now the second step is to get the common multiples.
So you can see here the common multiples are 36, then 72.
Okay, children.
So here we got two common multiples here at the starting.
But which one we will take? We will take the lowest one. Which is the lowest one?
Yes, the first multiple, that is 36. First we will write down the common multiples, that is 36, 72, and it will go on. HCF. Here also in the same method we will be doing the prime factorization, but a little bit difference is there. Let us see what is that. So here you can see our second method is prime factorization method, and for example we are going to take find the LCM of 50 and 16. So as we know in prime factorization we factorize both the numbers separately. So let us do that. So let us factorize 50 first. 2, 25 is then 5 by 25. Yes, children. Let us next factorize 16. So here we have to factorize till we get 1. Again, I am telling you this one. 2, 25 are 50. 5 into 5, 25. 5 into 1, 5. During HCF, we never bring down up to multiplied with 1, but in LCM you have to bring down the factorization up to 1. Okay, so that is why I have written 5 into 1, 5. Next is our 16. So let us take 2, 2, 13, 2, 15, 5, 3, 3, 1, 3. So we have factorized both the numbers up to the lowest, that is 1 and 1. Yes, children. So let us now write down the factors. Factors of 50 is equal to 2 into 5 into 5. 2 into 5 into 5. Let us now write down the factors of 16. Okay, 2 into 2, 2 into 2, into 5, into 3. So here we got 3 numbers, that is 2, 5 and 3. Here we got 3 numbers, that is 2, 5 and 3. Okay, now we will see which number we will take. 2. First, let us take 2. Where 2 has occurred many times? In this 50, 2 has occurred only once. But in factors of 60, 2 has occurred 2 times. So we will take this 2. Where the occurrence will be more, we will take those only. Okay? Here 2 has occurred 2 times, whereas 2 has occurred here 1 time. So we will take this as a to find out the LCM, that is 2 into 2. Next is 5. All of you see here where 5 has occurred more times. In the factors of 50, it has occurred 2 times. But in factors of 60, it has occurred only 1 time. So we have to take where the occurrence is more. That is, factors of 50, it has occurred 2 times. So now we will take 5 into 5. Our next number is 3. So we will take the number where it has occurred more. You can see in factors of 50, no 3 is there. 3 is not there. But in factors of 60, it has 1 3. So we have to take this 3. Okay? So I will multiply with 3. So we have to now find out the LCM by multiplying all these numbers. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 5, 20. 20 into 5, that is 100. 100 into 3 is 300. So our LCM is 300. LCM is 300. Repeating the steps, all of you listen. First, we have to factorize the numbers up to 1. Next step, we have to write down the factors of the given numbers. Step 3, what we have to see? Number, which numbers
many times it has been repeated. Occurrence means it has repeated many times.
So here 2 is repeated 2 times, so I have taken 2 times. Here 5 has been repeated 2 times, so I have taken 2 times 5. Here there is no 3, but here is 1 3, so I have taken 1 3. So it is 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 5, 20, 20 into 5, 100, 100 into 3, 300. So our LCM is 300. Okay, children.
Okay, children. So let us learn about the third method of LCM, that is division method. So it is same as we have done in HCF. We have to factorize both the numbers together. Okay? And we have to bring it to the lowest term up to 1. So let us see how it is done.
15, 16. We have to factorize it together.
Okay, children? So we have to take a number which will divide both the numbers, 50 and 60. Okay?
So let us take 2, 2, 25, then 30. Let us take 5, 5, 5 is 25, 5, 6 is 30. Next is, here you can take any one number, okay?
Any one number is divisible, you can do it. For example, if I take 2,
5 will not be divisible, but 5 will remain as 5.
Okay, if as I have taken 2, but 2 will be, 5 will be not divisible by 2.
So 5 will remain 5, whereas 6 will be divisible by 2, so 2, 3 is a 6.
Okay, children,
next if I take 5, 5 1 is a 5, it is divisible. But 3 is not divisible, so 3 will remain 3.
As we have to bring it to the lowest, that is 1, we have to go on dividing.
Now if I take 3, 1 will not be divisible, so 1 will remain as same. 3 1s are 3. So you can see now I have brought them to the lowest, that is 1 and 1. So let us now find out the LCM. LCM is equal to 2 into 5, 2 into 5, 2 into 5 into 3, 2 into 5 into 3.
Okay, children, so you have to remember in division method when we are factorizing, we have to bring them to the lowest, that is 1. But if both the numbers are not getting divisible, you can divide one number, okay? And other one will remain same.
Just like here, 2, I have taken, 6 will be divisible, but 5 will not be divisible. So 5 will remain 5, so 2, 3 is a 6.
So if both the numbers are not getting divisible, you can divide one number and get one.
So let us now find out the LCM, that is 2 into 5.
Yes,
10. 10 into 2.
20.
20 into 5,
100.
100 into 3 is 300. Yes, children. So you can see in the third method also, we have taken the same number, 50 and 60. And our LCM also, we got 300 as the same.
So understood all of you,
in the same number 1, we have to factorize both the numbers together. And we have to factorize till we get 1. Okay? And only this prime factors will be multiplying, they will be multiplying to get the LCM.
I hope you must have understood all of you all the three methods of LCM.